Hello everyone. Today I want to show you a video of liturgical abuse. This is a video of consider maybe a mass in Chicago, the Archdiocese of Chicago. So we're starting out with some praise and worship now. I'm fast forwarding here and watch a procession. Watch the priest in the back right there. He's high-fiving the kids in the procession into the church. So that's pretty funny. He's got a smile on his face. And watch when they bow. Okay, they bow to the altar, and then they turn around and they bow to the people. Here we go. That's pretty innovative. Now on the stage, well, the altar stage there, you can see there's a lady who is doing a sign language, every kind of modernist far left. Church has one of those sign language people in their church. So, I don't know. I mean, now does she need to be on the altar? Absolutely not. But they're having a fun time. Okay, so I decided to film this because you might have seen some of the stuff on Twitter. But I wanted to show you a little bit more of the liturgical abuse. I don't think I caught everything. I'm going to fast forward here.
Spirit be with each and every one of you.
And with your spirit.
In 20 seconds, I've already said Holy Spirit twice. And that gives you a powerful reminder of the pervasive energy of the Holy Spirit in our lives. We can often take it for granted, can we? But today, we really mark it. We heighten our spiritual awareness of the energy of the Holy Spirit. So I
is this Catholic
all of
or is
you.
It
thanks for getting the memo
pagan.
About wearing the red. Really appreciate that. Welcome to all of you joining us via this great instrument of the Holy Spirit, our live stream.
Oh boy.
Beloved Holy Family.
Lectura de los Hechos
okay,
de los Apóstoles.
So this first reading, there's
cuando llegó
speaking
el día
in Spanish.
De Pentecostés,
and I wanted to mention,
estaban todos juntos
I am
en el
recording
mismo lugar.
This. I recorded this video on their website, so the church website has this video. It's not on YouTube, and so the stream was a little bit more difficult to, what should I say, the buffering, it kept buffering. Oh, here we go, we're switching the language. So in the middle of the reading, they switched to a language that no one speaks in the United States, Igbo. But anyway, the stream was a little bit buffered a little bit more than I would like, so I pre-recorded this. Anyways, to this first reading here. Okay, so we've already had Spanish and Igbo. Oh, there we go. She read like a sentence, and then, I think this is, I don't know, is this Vietnamese Tagalog? I don't know what that is. But anyway, so this is kind of like during Pentecost. This is a Pentecost Mass. Oh, by the way, look for the tabernacle. I didn't actually see it. I didn't watch the whole Mass either. But anyway, this is kind of like Pentecost, where everyone's speaking in different languages, except it's like a reverse Pentecost. Because whenever St. Peter was speaking, everyone understood him, regardless of what language they spoke. Oh, here's Greek, but I don't think it's ancient Greek, unfortunately. Because then you would say Kyrie eleison. But anyway, I think the people understood. Now, these languages no one understands. At least in the United States, like very few people understand these languages. And so it's unnecessary to speak for them. But wouldn't it be interesting, wouldn't it be great if you could have one universal language for the liturgy? That everyone would understand no matter what language they spoke. Oh wait, we already have that. But unfortunately, not in the Novus Ordo. She switched to English there at the end. Okay, cool. Not really, I don't know. What do you think? How relevant, huh? And they start their... Now the first song was a praise and worship song. This is some kind of song.
The Gospel of the Lord.
So this is the deacon, and he read the Gospel. Nice. Okay. So I fast forwarded to a lot of things because the whole Mass, it wasn't...
Our Adventures in Grace has had a real
It says 3 hours,
Chicago
but it
structure.
Wasn't. It wasn't 3 hours. It was like more like two. Now here's the priest.
Table captains. tables. Aldermen, wards. Precinct captains, precincts. We really gathered and nurtured and identified 50 grace guides.
Grace guides.
They were a combination of all those Chicago structures.
So, see, the altar has
we
like a...
We wanted them to be a kind of a core energy behind this.
The pagan energy.
The reality is
there's
a one big grace
advertisement guide on the altar table.
And that
Adventures
is my
in
beloved
grace.
Friend, Terry Nelson Johnson. So, Ter, we welcome you once again, and with great gratitude for all the inspiration, for all the animation of faith, for all the craziness, and all of the deeply profound that you have brought to us. So how about one more really warm welcome for Terry Nelson Johnson?
And this says, Adventures in Grace, Live, Dance, Love, and here he's calling up a lay guy to give the homily, so there you go, that's a liturgical abuse for sure. What the heck is this stupid song? Live, Dance, Love. No. Like, this is a Catholic church. What about salvation of souls? What about the sacrifice of the Mass?
That's some good church right there, people.
That's some good church, guys. All right, I'm fast-forwarding it.
You know, I've mentioned a number of times that when I was in school, I was in the slow group, the blue group, the slow group. And so when I listen to the scriptures, I just hope that one idea, one line, one word stirs something in my
life. All right, so now I actually am.
I noticed that sitting next to them was a bubble wand sitting in what one can only imagine was bubble solution. I'm not sure what came over me. I walked over and said, "Do you mind if I make a few bubbles?" They both nodded in affirmation. And so I went over. I grabbed the wand.
He told a story.
Stirred up the solution a little
bit. I spared
bit.
You all the details. But this is, remember, this is during a homily.
I
look,
this is going to work.
There's a lady in a wheelchair, and I don't know if those are her kids or what, but those kids look pretty bored. And they don't look impressed. And they're forced to wear stuff over their faces, huh?
Yeah, that's what we're talking about.
And then they're just kind of like, yeah. I hate being.
Oh!
They're kind of like, yeah. Why am I here?
Oh, I'm pretty sure this is the first time this has happened at the feet of the cross of new life.
Okay, so.
Are you kidding me? Oh my gosh! Let's hear it for Bubbles.
Yeah, let's hear it for Bubbles. That's so relevant.
Oh.
I don't understand why these people
are
even coming here.
Oh my gosh, so joyful.
As you can see more and more, this is like a pagan service. It's like some kind of
the little girl
pseudo-Protestant pagan
the
service.
Promise me that you'll give faith-fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out,
all right, I fast-forwarded here.
And so using some of the language of the song that we just sang, I would invite you to enthusiastically respond, "I will," to these questions.
So this is kind of like a mockery of the baptismal vows.
Will you trust in the loving and lyrical God who is asking you to dance?
Lyrical God who's asking you to
will you commit
dance?
To the life of active and engaged faith that lies ahead? Will you mediate grace and be the body of Christ to your family, friends, co-workers, and society? Will you commit to our faith community's continued adventures in grace by generously sharing your time, your talent, and your resources? When given the choice to sit out or dance, will you dance?
What?
All of us have needs and things that bother or hurt us at this time of every Eucharist.
What is he talked about dancing. What's open the our hearts, fruity reason behind that?
We also have an energy of petition.
Oh, there we go. God. Pagan energy.
With things that bother us or hurt us, things we're grateful for. So let's take this opportunity once again and time after time to offer our prayers to God.
If you're lost, you can look, you will find me. Time after time. If you fall, I will catch you, I'll be waiting. Time after time.
Oh, have you guys seen Napoleon Dynamite?
If you're lost, you can look, and you will find me.
I like your sleeves. They're real big.
Time after time. If you fall, I will catch you, I will be waiting.
I mean, can you believe this?
For all who minister in the church, may they be enlightened and energized by the Holy
Here's
Spirit
the petitions.
As they serve the body of Christ and all God's children. For world leaders, may they work to bring a true and lasting peace to their nations and their regions, a peace to be shared and enjoyed by all. For all those who were welcomed into the church this Easter, who received the Holy Spirit in baptism and confirmation, may they grow in realization and appreciation for the Spirit's gifts. May the sin of racism be banished from all hearts. And may we continue to break down all walls that divide us.
Walls.
Just as the Holy Spirit broke down language and ethnic barriers on that first Pentecost.
Yeah, but you're putting the barriers back up.
For an enduring love of all human life.
Oh, no.
So that all people may refrain from the deliberate taking of any human life. We remember families impacted by ongoing violence in our own city of Chicago. And we now take an intentional moment of silence.
Moment of silence in a Catholic church.
To remember and pray for all those impacted by the senseless violence, most recently in Texas and Oklahoma.
Wow, look at the emotion. You can tell the emotion in her voice, and it's kind of like a play almost. But then we're taking a moment of silence in a Catholic church. What about a moment of prayer? Or maybe we're non-denominational.
May our prayers and intentions manifest into action, policy,
action,
and mental health resources that prevent these violent acts from happening again.
So, political.
May God's grace, peace, and comfort be with all victims of violence. May God's divine spirit of mercy protect and guide the people of Ukraine.
Political.
And may all those in harm's way be protected.
Celebrate this Eucharist today.
All right. For on We're the day fast forwarding to the consecration.
Suffer, Jesus himself took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to
he
his
He has
disciples.
To show everyone, even though everyone can see it.
He said, take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up.
And that's a valid consecration, but then he holds it up. You're not holding it up with two hands?
Let's all be instruments of the reverence of the Holy Spirit. Let us all bow.
So he bowed instead of genuflected, and that's not even a...
And in a like manner, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice again, giving you thanks and praise.
So the chalice, with quotes on it, is actually just a clear glass.
Drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be poured out for you, shed for you and for all, for the forgiveness of sins.
Okay, for all. Note that. That's liturgical abuse.
the mystery of faith.
No bow, no genuflection. There
so
you
folks,
go.
Our celebration continues out in the
courtyard. All right, so this is after Mass.
The forecast
like,
for a while
well, at the end of Mass.
Be overcast and some
or,
rain.
Well, they'd probably call it a service.
That the Holy Spirit has kind of just blown all that away with a very strong breath.
That's hilarious. Clapping. Lots of clapping.
So we have a beautiful
lots of popular
day
music.
To celebrate in a beautiful courtyard with
praise and worship. Whatever.
Let's all stand. My friends, the Lord is with you.
The Lord is with you.
Let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. May the God who has redeemed you and made you adopted children through the resurrection of his only Son bless you and fill you with joy. Amen. May the Holy Spirit, who has bestowed you many gifts, inspire you to live, dance, and love.
What
and
is up with the fruity dancing?
That experience. Amen. May the God who joined us in Christ's resurrection by faith and baptism help us to return to new life and lead us to live justly so as to bring us to the home of our God in heaven. Amen. Amen. And may Almighty God bless us today,
may
Father,
God
Son,
bless us.
And Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
The Mass never ends.
The Mass never ends. Alleluia. I'm pretty sure that's Alleluia. Not correct. I'm not a Novus Ordo liturgical expert. But, Ite Mesa Est. Alleluia. The Mass is ended.
Alleluia.
They just make up their own prayers.
And as an example that the Mass never ends, please be seated.
That's so funny. Not really. This is a mockery. I mean, even of the Novus Ordo. He invites the lay guy up to give another homily. There we go.
Hey, thank you for indulging us. It is the church's birthday, so the fact that it's a longer celebration sort of makes sense. This will not add a lot of time, but I think it will be worth it, so thank you in advance. So,
wow.
Remember when you went to that 8th grade dance and you were not a dancer, but you promised yourself, I'm going to dance
once, I fast forwarded a little bit.
Just once. And then your palms started to sweat, and then the DJ says, the last dance, and you have not been out there yet? Like, this is it, people. This is where we are right now in this celebration. So we're going to play a closing song, which you will have to work hard at to not dance. You will have to work hard at it. I'd like you to consider your dance as an amen. You know how I say amen is not a word of relief, it's a word of assent? It's not like, oh, we get to leave now and go have a hot dog, although you will. Except, you know how when they say you got to dance, you got to sing for your supper? You got to dance for your hot dog, people.
Okay, so if you're a straight man that
attends
this Mass,
you know, we say amen should cost you.
I don't know what to say.
In the short term, the amen
with all this dancing nonsense.
Those of you who are dancers, those 10%, we just need you here right now. The 50% who are like, oh, maybe a little bit. Those last 40%, this is where we want you to jump in and embody your amen.
And really, if you attend this Mass at all, what is your problem?
It's not a gimmick.
Like, come on.
This is a
commitment
to be a living ambassadors of Pentecost and grace in our broken, beautiful world. And so during this last song, I'm going to ask all of us, just give us 90 seconds. Don't give me the, I don't dance, I haven't had wine. Don't give me that.
Oh, I mean, this is basically...
90 seconds.
This place is basically like a playhouse.
Shake it a little bit. I know you can do it. Those of you who are rolling your eyes now,
or
get
theater,
up and roll
I guess
them.
You would call it.
And shake it. You know what I'm saying? So we're going to move into the aisles, and we're just going to give each other... 90 seconds.
Yeah, move into the aisles. Okay, now you're talking about an event hall.
And if you want to.
So you might as well put
added,
a bar in the back and serve alcohol.
I will be outside near the hot
you're gonna
dogs
see what's gonna
with
happen.
A bunch of bubble wands. But nobody who doesn't
oh,
dance can
great.
Touch a bubble wand. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Get up, get up.
There's the applause.
Go into the aisles, into the aisles. Go on, people.
Let's go, church. Put your hands together.
Shake it. Shake it, baby.
This is your amen. All right. You know what helps
come on
you
now.
Woo! Woo! Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Oh, yeah. church. Look at the priest. He's breaking it down on the altar. Oh, yeah. Okay, so this is, this is Cardinal Supich's diocese, but you know what? You know what I have to say when I watch this? I think we need to ban the Latin Mass. There's a lot of people there too. What's the deal with that? Are any of them Catholic? I mean, like, really, do any of them believe in the Catholic faith? All right, well, that was really embarrassing. So, anyway, thanks for watching. We are the laity, and we will not be silent.